Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to install the latest version of NetBeans IDE, that is version 20, on a Windows 10 operating system. And after that, I'm also going to show you how you can easily run a simple Hello World Java program on our NetBeans IDE. So do watch the video till the end. I can promise you will be learning a lot of new things. So do watch the video till the end, and if you face any issues, you can always put a comment in our comment sections. I'll try my best to help you. So without any delay, let's start our video. Now to install NetBeans IDE, the first thing that you will need is Java. So if you go to your browser, so here this link I am going to provide right in our description. So from here you need to download the latest version of Java, which is JDK 21. If you want to download a bit older version like JDK 17, probably in your project you might need JDK 17. So for that you can just simply switch to JDK 17 tab, and you can switch to your operating system like Linux, macOS or Windows, and you can download the respective exe. So this is for Java 17 and this is for JDK 21. Alright, so in my previous videos I have shown you how to install Java JDK 21. So you need to follow that video and install it locally on your system. Once you have that, you are ready to install NetBeans. Alright, so hopefully you have Java already installed. So now you can just simply again open a new tab and just simply type over here NetBeans download, and it will show you this netbeans.apache.org as a first search result. So here you need to just simply click on this download button, and it's going to redirect to the official site of Apache NetBeans. Again, this link I'm going to put right in our description. So once you land over this site, you'll be able to see the latest version of NetBeans currently is 20. So probably when you'll be watching it, it could be 21 or 22. So the process will be pretty much same, I can guarantee you that. Okay, so if you still face any issues, always you can put a comment, your question in our comment sections. I'll try my best to help you. Okay, so currently the version is 20, so you need to click on this download button, and it's going to redirect to this page. Again here you need to click on this link for Windows, so click on that, and it's going to redirect to Apache Software Foundation page, and from here you need to click on this link. So when you click on that, it's going to start downloading our NetBeans version 20. Now since I have already downloaded it, so I'll just simply cancel this. I'll also minimize my browser. I'll go to my download directory, and here you can see the same exe, and that is Apache NetBeans version 20, is already been downloaded over here. So to install, you need to just simply double click on the installer, and it's going to ask you for administrative privileges. Just simply click on yes. And you can see it is rightly started configuring the installer. So alright, so during this time only it's going to detect whether you have Java already there or not. You can minimize our download directory, and here you can see that our installation wizard for Apache NetBeans is rightly open. So these are all things that they're going to install, that is our base IDE, which is the NetBeans IDE itself. Then you can use Java software edition or enterprise edition. So both Java version you can use, then HTML5, JavaScript, PHP, and all these different languages also you can use. Alright, so you need to just simply click on next over here, and this is our license agreement. You can accept this license agreement and click on next over here, and this is what I was talking about. Alright, so now that I have Java installed, so that path is rightly recognized over here. Alright. So that's why I keep on telling at the very beginning of the video that you need to have Java installed. So it doesn't matter if you have Java 17 also, then it should be showing JDK 17. Okay, that's totally fine. So the thing is, you need to have JDK installed, version 8 and above. Alright, so here is our NetBeans 20. So they're going to create this NetBeans 20 folder, and they have found Java. So now it is ready to be installed. So click on next. So check for updates is fine, and this is our total installation size, so that much free space you need to have on our C drive. Alright, so that's the one point you need to note, and everything is fine. Click on install, and you can see our installation has rightly begun. So this installing will take some time, about 3 to 4 minutes I would say. So after that I'm going to again come back to this video. Yep, so welcome back. And now you can clearly see that our Apache NetBeans IDE is successfully installed. So all plugins are updated to launch IDE. You can just simply go to start menu, or you can use the desktop shortcut icon. So what basically they are telling is you can use or desktop shortcut icon, or you can go to search and just simply type here NetBeans, and that will also show you the software link. Okay, so that is fine. You can just simply click on finish. You can just simply double click on the Apache NetBeans IDE from the desktop shortcut to launch it, and you can see it is rightly started launching, and it has rightly launched. So Apache NetBeans IDE version 20 is rightly launched. You can close this start page tab for now, and you can quickly jump over to the file menu and click on new project. So we are going to show about how to create a new Java project. So I'll choose Java with AND, and I'm going to choose Java application over here and click on next. So it's going to first start configuring our Java cluster, and then it's going to activate it. So give you a couple of minutes over here, and you can see that our project is almost created. So here it is asking to give a project name. So I'm going to remove everything, and I'm going to give the project name as Hello World. And you can see that it has also properly given our project folder name, which is also Hello World, and it's going to create our main class. So Hello World will be our package. So you can see that H is starting with small, so this is our package name, and then dot, then this Hello World is our class name. Alright, so everything is fine. You can just simply click on finish over here, and it's going to start creating our project, and you can see that our Hello World project is rightly created over here. So here if we expand this Hello World, you can see that we have source packages and then libraries. So if we expand this, you can see that our Hello World package that we have created is rightly over here. And again, if we expand this, you can see that our class HelloWorld.java is rightly opened over here. So the same file, okay. And if you expand libraries, here you will see all JDK libraries. So if I expand this again, you can see these are all libraries, okay, system libraries for JDK. So all these libraries are actually getting used to write all this program. All right. So here into just simply, hit enter and just simply do system.out.println, then welcome, just a string. And if you just simply click on this run button, it's going to save our file, and it's going to start building our project. And once our project gets successfully built, you can see the output welcome is rightly shown in our console. So like this, you can do any sort of Java program on our NetBeans IDE. Probably you might be getting assignments from your school or college, so you can work on those assignments in our NetBeans IDE. Alright, so that's pretty much all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video. If this video really helped you, then please give it a like, and also don't forget to subscribe our channel. That will really help me to make more such videos. And I have also started one blogging channel, so if you're interested, you can always subscribe their channel, and you can also watch those videos. So yeah, that's pretty much all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.